The next page to focus on is the users page. The users page and the devices page have a lot of similarities. The big difference is the columns displayed in the users table and also the fields that we can filter on using the query wizard. In my environment, I have the Microsoft Active Directory adapter enabled, which can also pull in user information about the users within our environment. Let's start by adding additional columns to our user table. The columns that we're going to add are Axonius aggregated columns. Let's select first name, last name, and is locked. Let's also save the displayed columns as our user default. If multiple adapters were enabled that had the ability to pull user information, we'd also be able to select the adapter connections column and expand to view all of the associated adapter connections with each user in the user table. By selecting a row in the user table, we'll be navigated to the profile page for that user. Within this page, we can see the adapter connections that are associated with this user, and we can also use the custom data tab to view, add, or remove custom fields. Next, let's review the data in the aggregated tab. This tab is going to show similar information in my environment since I only have one adapter enabled. In any case, Axonius will normalize and deduplicate assets in the form of users if multiple adapters are reporting on the same user. Depending on which adapters you have enabled, you'll see additional tabs under the aggregated tab. In our case, we see associated devices. This view lets us know that this user is associated with two devices. In the aggregated tab, we can export the results as a CSV and click on the rows within the table to pivot to the devices page. In the profile page for users, Axonius also allows you to add notes and tags for each selected user. Let's return back to the users page and perform a few queries using the query wizard. In our first use case, we're going to attempt to find administrator users that have been locked out of their accounts. To do this, we can click on the query wizard and select an adapter that we're going to be performing searches against. For our environment, we're going to use the aggregated Axonius field and search for fields that indicate whether or not a user is an administrator. Let's select the isAdmin field. Since we're searching for whether or not a user is an admin, our operator is going to be set to true. In this query, we'll need one more filter expression. The second filter expression that we'd like to add is whether or not a user is locked out of their account. We can duplicate the existing row and search for the field isLocked. And again, we're going to leave our operator set to true since we're looking for users locked out of their account. Now let's save this query filter by clicking on Save As. Provide the query a name and an optional description and tags. As an example, let's build one more query in the users page, and we'll start off by clicking the reset button next to Save As. In our next use case, we're going to use the query wizard to search for administrator users that have not been seen in the Active Directory domain in the last 30 days. We can build this query by selecting Axonius aggregated as our adapter and isAdmin as our field. Again, we're looking for administrator users, so our operator is going to be set to true. We'll use the duplicate row again to make a copy of the first filter expression and change the field for the second expression to last seen in domain. The operator that we're going to select is last days. We're searching for administrator users that have not been seen in the last 30 days. We will enter 30 as our value and select the not flag to find the inverse of this query filter. Let's also save this filter by giving it a name, description, and tags. In the users page, we can also view the saved queries that we've built by clicking on Saved Queries. The user's saved queries page has all of the same features as the device's saved queries page. If we were to click on a saved query in the table, then we'll have the same options to edit, copy, create a new enforcement, duplicate, and delete our saved query. By clicking on a single or multiple rows in the saved queries table, we can also delete saved queries and add tags on the fly. Next, let's take a quick glance at the query history for the queries performed on the user's page. From this page, we can view saved and unsaved queries and rerun a query listed in the table by clicking on the row. Next, let's take a look at how we can export information from the user's table. Just like in the devices page, the first step is to add the columns that we'd like to be presented in the data export by clicking on Edit Columns. After that's complete, click on Export CSV, provide a name for the file, whether or not you'd like to split assets by entities or field values, and select a delimiter if you'd like. Then click Export. By selecting a single or multiple users in the users table, you can also add tags, delete users, link and unlink users, create enforcements, filter out results from the query, and add custom fields.